will explain everything to us. Jesus declares, I will speak to you and eat. And they gave her water jar, the woman went back to town and said to all the people, come and see a man that called me everything I ever did. Could this be Christ? And God bless this holy word in our hearing and understanding. Surely John must have been mistaken in the way in which he recorded this account in the life of our Lord. God couldn't be like this, acting the way Jesus does with this woman at the well of Samaria. For the purpose of John's gospel is to show Jesus as the revealer of the true God. Jesus even said, he who has seen me has seen the Father. And for the most part, John does a great job. But here, in this text, God can't be like this, being interested in anyone and everyone and caring about them, even the not-so-nice people. I mean, let's get real. This lady is really too much. She's rude to Jesus. Did you hear her say, how is it that you, a Jew, and I, a Samaritan woman, should be talking to one another? And by the way, what do you mean, giving me a drink? You don't have a bucket. How are you going to draw water? The well is deep. She misunderstood everything Jesus said. She's of the wrong religion and her morals. Oh, my gosh. Five husbands, and now she's shacking up with another man. God couldn't be like this unless he has an overwhelming desire to love us all down to the very last one of us. All of us who are terribly mixed up in life and don't know where we are going. God can't be like this unless he has something up his sleeve that can handle the likes of the worst of us as well as the best of us. God just can't be like this unless he is a God who could call an unknown man by the name of Abram and suffer through all his problems because the world was such a mess, and he wanted to make it well. God couldn't be like this unless he is a God, as St. Paul claimed, a God who justifies the ungodly, makes the good, and gives life to the dead, all kinds of dead people, and calls into existence those things that do not exist. But that is exactly who he is. God couldn't be like this because Jesus' first words to this woman were a word of promise, not a word of judgment. He spoke a promise, not a command. He gave an invitation that was not first a challenge. Did he hear that promise? Woman, if you knew the gift of God, and who it is that asks you for a drink, you would have asked him for a drink, and he would have given you living water that wells up the springs of eternal joy. What a promise! And to someone who's not very pious, and certainly not very good. God can't be like this unless he is bound and determined to give himself for no other reason than that you and I need him in our lives. God can't be like this unless he is willing to give his gift of life just for the extra. Why, one could even baptize an infant and dare to believe that in that act, Jesus is claiming that child to be the receiver of his gift of life, even before that child can do anything but eat and wet and cry. And so it is true. But just when you and I think that God might be like some overindulgent parent, and I suspect that that's an idea that most of us could be comfortable with, we are astonished once again. For out of the clear blue sky, Jesus upfront and personal with people, would he? God couldn't be like that. Blessed the promise of his power within us means a love so great that we can afford to be honest with him, with ourselves, and with one another. God can't be like that unless he insists on a cure that really works on the troubles that we have in our life. You see, what kills us is that we really thirst for God himself, although oftentimes we don't know it, and we wouldn't have it. This woman was hardly aware that she even had a problem, let alone what that problem might be. She wasn't looking for God. She didn't know she needed God. But God found her. Amen. Yes, you see, Jesus always is very personal. And that must make him the true God. For many of us, our ideas about weakness, problems, and sins are often pretty shallow and hasty. But when the living Lord zeroes in on our life, he touches our most vulnerable spots, like our incorrigible jealousy, our incredible need to always be center stage, and our pathological fear of people that are not exactly like ourselves. He gets very personal and often very embarrassing. And that's how you and I can know that he is the true God, because the true God deals with real problems. That scripture tells us he comes to kill in order to make you alive.
Right.
And those who are truly dead, he raises to life again. God can't be like that unless he wants to truly make us well again. And that, my friends, is exactly what he wants to do today. If you and I need final proof that God can be like the Jesus of this text, then we have it right there, clearly written black words on white paper. Jesus told this woman that religion is not where it's at. What kind of God would say that? You remember that this embarrassed but impressed woman finally does get around to asking a religious question. The religious question: what is the true faith? Is it yours, O Jewish man, or is it mine? Perhaps all I need to do is just adjust things a little bit and work a little harder. Just following the steps of so many people in our world today, they're convinced that the answer to their problem is to find the true religion and to do things a little better. And did she ever get an answer? Jesus said, time is coming when you will neither worship here or in Jerusalem. You see, the question is not what or where you should worship, but who you should worship. Do you know who he is? He is the God of the present moment. He is not the God of some hazy past or far distant future. He is the God who breaks into the present moment, claiming you for himself. The time is now. The place is here. God is real, and he is here for you. But God can't be like that unless he insists that the issue is never one of whose religion is right or whose church is best. The issue is that every moment and every place is pregnant with the reality of God reaching out to touch you and gather you in and make you well again and get you going in the right direction. The issue is not that you should find God. That's the escape into a religion of yesterday or a tomorrow of pious hopes. The time is for God to touch you is right now in this moment. Isn't that great? For in the end, the key is not what you and I should do. The issue is what Jesus did when he hung on the cross of Calvary and paid the penalty for our sins and opened to us the promise of life eternal. Now let's get down to it. God really wouldn't be like this unless, in fact, Jesus is God.
Right.
And that is true, my friend. Jesus is the one who makes everything possible. He is the one who you and I are privileged to say in the words of Thomas, "My Lord and my God." And that makes taking him at his word when he says, "Friend, I am the one for you." You know, this story really doesn't have a very good ending. If you continue reading through the fourth chapter of John, we don't really find out what happened to this woman. Except that in her excitement, she left her water jar and ran off to the village to tell everyone about a man who told her everything she'd ever done and asked the question, could this be the Christ?
Right.
But does her story end in tragedy or in comedy? Does it have a happy ending or a sad ending? Was this woman really changed for eternity? Did she receive the promise of water welling up within her springs of eternal life? We don't really know. And that's good. Because this text is not really a story about a woman and a well scenario. This is a story about Jesus. How much he wants you and I to receive living water. Will you receive that gift? Will you hear anew this day that Jesus is the one who says, "I am the one for you"? And know that you and I have once again been found anew by His Holy Spirit. Am I willing to simply ask and receive His unfathomable offer of grace? Can it be that you and I, just as we are, can indeed possessors of a spring of water welling up eternal life? God can't be like this. It's too good to be true. But it is true.
Amen.
Thanks be to God who gives us the victory in our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God's people said,
Amen.
He's a God who's